The views expressed and the opinions given by the individual host and their guests do not necessarily reflect those of ParaX, its affiliates, or its sponsors.
The following program contains opinions expressed by the Dead Zone. If you find this broadcast offensive, lighten up, candy ass.
What?
Oh my gosh.
It's a radio show.
Hell yeah! That's what I'm talking about.
Initialize sequence now.
We're now in the approach phase. Everything looking good.
Ready to remove the old outputs.
Hang on, grid control is good. 5,
Roger, time.
4, 3,
go now.
2, 1,
engage.
Dead Zone WDZR-TV Worldwide. Welcome to the Dead Zone Paranormal Radio Show.
November 1st. Hope you all had a great, safe Halloween last night. Coming up, we're going to do our normal Halloween show since we seem to never be on the day of Halloween. We do a post-Halloween show, and we're going to showcase different music picked by the members of the Dead Zone, and we hope you enjoy it. So to start off, a couple of my favorites, Riggs, or as you know, Scum of the Earth. We're going to do a couple of those. Might even throw in some League of Corruption with Something's in the Water.
Ha 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 ha!
This is Rick McCullum of the Hollywood Ghost Hunters, and you're listening to The Dead Zone.
Dead Zone, WDZR-DB, worldwide.
We'll be right back.
Okay, I like that. I've got one more coming up from Scum, Black Tractor, and By Lord. Stick around. You're going to love it.
My name is David Walton. I am a vocal performer for What Are You Afraid Of? Horror and Paranormal Show. And I have carried the burden of a terrible secret. I am actually what is offensively called a ghost. For years now, I have concealed my ectoplasmic existence from my friends and family in fear of a common prejudice against ghosts, or what we like to call the disembodied. I have existed frightened of being discovered, unable to do physical acts that the embodied take for granted, such as walking a squirrel or drinking a glass of vitamin E milk fresh squeezed from a whale. I grew depressed and even considered acts of self-harm or reincarnation, which is suicide for the disembodied. Such movies as Ghostbusters and its sequels drove my feelings of disenfranchisement, and I began looking for help only to encounter painful exorcisms in the houses I haunted. Then I met two good people, it says here, Fox and Phil, at What Are You Afraid Of? Horror and Paranormal. And they helped me take control of my own life. Now, it is my choice whether I wish to make phantom bangs in the night, appear at the foot of your bed in darkness, or make your walls bleed. If you are a disembodied person like I am, and you're living a lie, What Are You Afraid Of? Can help you too. They are on at 9 p.m. on Friday nights at Para X Radio, leaving plenty of time for midnight haunting activities, and can be found on all major podcast services. Listen to their paranormal stories, interviews, humorous sketches and horror fiction to know that you are not alone. And if you are a member of the embodied, don't forget, you are only a single heart attack or tumour away from becoming one of us. This is David Walton. See you on the other side. Or as I call it, this side.
And that is the end of a perfect day.
Yeah. Good evening. I am Sammy Terry, and you're listening to the Dead Zone.
Your source for everything paranormal. Para X.
Okay, I hope you guys are still with us, and if you are, awesome. We're going to go with Scott Blake, our old buddy, man. He'll be back soon, I guarantee you. He's got to get through this pandemic and everything that's going on, but John 5 and Necrogoblicon, two of his favorites that we can play, and we're going to do it right now.
Okay. millions of people are affected by the Para-X bug.
I realize that it is something that will stay with me for the rest of my life and long into the afterlife as well.
If you have the Para-X bug, there is hope.
With a nightly visit to the Para-X website and intensive past life regression therapy, I can control it.
Even with the Para-X bug, I can still lead an active life of radio show hosting, paranormal investigating, evidence checking, attending conferences, book writing, keeping up with the latest technology, and still keep my 40-hour-a-week day job.
If you think that you have the Para-X bug or know someone who might, visit para-x.com. And remember, you are not alone.
I am not alone.
I
am not alone.
The Para-X bug may cause the urge to chase shadow people, visit exotic haunted locations, adopt a pug wedgie, or spend all of your time trying to figure out the laws and principles of paranormal investigation. Listening to Para-X may increase these effects.
Sudden visions of full-body apparitions or feeling the covers being pulled off you in the middle of the night by unseen hands may also be signs of exposure to the Para-X bug.
The use of Para-X may be habit-forming, and an overwhelming desire to provoke spirits may be a serious side effect. If these symptoms last more than 4 hours, you should quickly consult a trusted witch and have her cast a "What the hell are you thinking?" spell on you. If symptoms persist, please contact the Para-X Radio Network Homeland Security Team for further instructions.
The Para-X bug may cause urges for late-night speaking with spirits and ghosts. Listening to Para-X may increase these effects. Overwhelming desire to try provoking a spirit may be a serious side effect. Those with Para-X bug effects lasting more than 4 hours should consult Para-X or see a professional. Sudden outbursts at the mention of orbs may be a sign of exposure to the Para-X bug. Use of Para-X may be habitable. Use caution when engaging in Para-X treatment.
Can't remember you. This is the Dead Zone Paranormal Radio Show.
Thanks for listening.